There are serious questions tonight surrounding the district attorney's office's witness protection system. This after a man whose brother testified in a high-profile murder case was killed Saturday night. It's a story we first broke earlier today on WDSU.com. The victim's brother testified in the murder trial of Telly Hankton, also known as one of the most dangerous men in New Orleans. WDSU reporter Tiffany Bradley is on your side with what this killing could mean for the future of murder investigations. That's tonight's big local story.
New Orleans police have confirmed that a 61-year-old man shot to death outside of this Jazz Daiquiri and Lounge on Claiborne Avenue Saturday night is indeed the brother of a man who was a key witness in the Telly Hankton trial last month.
A brutal uptown murder could be linked to the city's most dangerous criminal, who's now behind bars. Curtis Matthews, the co-owner of this daiquiri shop, was gunned down in front of his business Saturday night. Neighbors didn't seem surprised over the killing.
That's not the first time that I've heard of shootings and stuff like that.
But this shooting comes days after a high-profile criminal, Telly Hankton, was sentenced to life in prison for murder. Curtis Matthews was the brother of the man who helped put Hankton behind bars. Back in September, John Matthews testified he was almost certain Hankton shot and killed Darnell Stewart in front of his daiquiri shop in May 2008.
They can't get you, they get your wife, they get your kid.
Criminologist Peter Scharf says the recent homicide is a huge blow to the criminal justice system.
How are all these great people in the DA's witness assistance program going to convince people to testify against organized drug interests?
A spokesperson with the Orleans Parish District Attorney's Office says they can't comment on protection procedures for witnesses. Meantime, Hankton is awaiting trial on a second murder charge. Scharf says most of the city's murders are drug-related, and with an average of 15 murders a month, Scharf says those crimes will go unsolved if witnesses are afraid to talk.
If they can get away with killing witnesses who oppose the drug interests, this is going to be a sad city, and we're in for a very rough ride.
So far, police have not arrested anyone in connection with Saturday night's murder. On your side, uptown, Tiffany Bradley, WDSU News.
And the man who testified in the Hankton case, John Matthews, was shot 17 times last October. Police believe it was an attempt to stop Matthews from testifying in the Hankton trial.